What's up everyone? Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be making bismuth crystals. Let's get started. To make these bismuth crystals, you'll need some tongs, quite a couple cloths, baking paper, a silicone mold, some paper towel, a metal fork, some bismuth, and a second-hand pot. Now we're gonna be melting our bismuth. Children, if you're trying to make bismuth crystals, make sure you get an adult to supervise you or help you. So let's start by turning on the heat. We're gonna put it on a 7 heat for now, and then we're gonna later change it to 9. So now we're going to take our bismuth out and put it in the pan. So we're just going to drop it in and then we're going to wait for it to melt. If you see any gunk, use a fork to get it out and put it onto your paper towel. So now all we have to do is wait for our bismuth to melt. Bismuth has melted, we can go on to pouring it in our silicone mold. So I'm just gonna pick this up and move it over here and pour it into our silicone mold. So now that we've poured our bismuth into our silicone mold, we can wrap it up in our cloth and baking paper. Paper on first, wrap it in my tiny cloth, and then we're going to wrap it into the paper. Now that we've wrapped it in cloth, to slow down the cooling process, we can wait 10 minutes until some of it is still liquidy and some of it is in its crystalline form. The time may vary depending on how much bismuth you have. Now that it's been approximately 5 minutes, we can check how our solution is doing. We're going to uncover it here and be very, very careful because it is still hot. And let's give it a little tap to see if there's still any liquid. There is still some liquid, so now we can pour the rest of the liquid back in there. We're going to take some of the top off to see if we can see the crystals. After a lot of trial and error with the timing, we finally got some crystals that we really like. They are not extremely colorful, but they still have color. As you can see in this one, and this one. This one has quite a lot of gunk on it, as it was one of our first batches. They all have a nice formation of their crystalline structure, as you can see with these lines here and these lines here. They're very beautiful and very colorful, and I really enjoyed making them. So, now that we've finished growing our crystals, make sure you hit that like button, smash that subscribe button, ring the notification bell, and check out some of my other videos. Thanks for watching!